世界各国の農業者や農業団体との連携につきましてお話をさせていただきます。冒頭申し上げましたとおり、去る4月、世界で唯一の国際的な農業団体組織である世界農業者機構 WFO の総会が私の地元新潟県で開催をされました。日本での開催は初めてでありましたが、アジアや欧米などから250人ものの農業者が集い、国境を越えて各国の農業の発展を目指して議論を深めることができたと思っております。
Now I would like to point out how we have been busy developing our partnership and cooperation globally with other agriculture organizations and farmers all over the world as a JA group. Now, as I mentioned at the outset, in April, we have successfully completed the General Assembly of the WFO, World Farmers Organization, which is the only international organization consisting of numerous regions and agricultural organizations. And this General Assembly was held in Niigata Prefecture, which is my home prefecture, it was my pleasure to say. And this was the first time that this General Assembly of WFO was held in Japan. And 250 farmers from Asia and Europe, United States, and every continent have gathered. And regardless of the different nationalities and different views, across the borders, we have been able to avidly discuss about what agriculture should be aimed at.
特に今回はお手元にお配りいたしているとおり、貿易協定において農業は他の経済分野と異なる取り扱いが必要とする見解を発表しておりまして、世界の農業者が持続的な農業生産や食料自給の大切さを確認した意義は非常に大きいものと言えます。さらに WFO に加盟している農業団体はアメリカやオーストラリアなどの農畜産物の輸出国と日本のような輸入国、加えて先進国とか途上国、農業の置かれている立場は様々で、貿易問題に対する考え方も違います。そのような中で意見や立場の違いを乗り越えまして、食料安全保障や農村の重要性を踏まえた農業分野への配慮が不可欠との見解を示すことができたのは、誠に価値ある成果であったと評価をいたしております。
In your handout, there is a WHO trade policy paper that was developed in conclusion of this General Assembly, and here it states that agriculture must also continue to be treated differently from other economic sectors in trade agreements. And this was agreed by farmers from all over the world because we have all confirmed this common aim, a vision that the sustainable agricultural production and self-sufficiency of food is extremely important, and it's a prerequisite. And also, the agricultural organizations that are members of WFO are quite diverse in their circumstances and their viewpoints, such as the United States and Australia. These are the exporting countries, major exporting countries of agriculture and livestock products. There are the members, as well as Japan and other importing countries, developing countries, less developed, least developed countries, advanced countries, and therefore there's this variety of views and circumstances and environment that have been represented in WFO, and we have diverse views on trade issues. However, in spite of these differences, we have come to the common understanding and common vision that the recognition of the fundamental importance of food security and rural areas is extremely important, and that is the rationale for the different treatment of agriculture.
また来週には私が団長となってアメリカに代表団を派遣し、 TPP についての日本の農業者の考えを強く訴えてくる予定としております。また現地の農業団体と共通の取り組みを追求するために意見交換も予定をいたしております。具体的な予定を申し上げますと、全米生乳生産者連盟や米国米連合、米国砂糖連盟などの個別生産品目の農業団体との意見交換を行うとともに、 WFO にも加盟しているファーマーズユニオンのロジャー・ジョンソン会長との会談を6月11日に ワシントンにおいて行います。本日お手元にお配りしておりますすでに5月の TPP 交渉リマ会合に際しまして、私とジョンソン会長の連名で TPP が農業のみならず医療制度への悪影響を与えることの危険性や交渉プロセスの透明性確保の必要性等につきましても共同声明を出していることもありまして、今回も会談を実のあるものにしてくると確信をいたしております。
And next week I will be leading this delegation to the United States to appeal the Japanese agriculture's farmers' voices regarding TPP at various places. Now, in order to pursue the common agenda and the common actions as the agriculture organizations and to develop collaborations, we plan to have various meetings for the exchange of views. Just to give you some, we shall be meeting with representatives of NMPF, National Milk Producers Federation, as well as the USA Rice Federation and ASA, American Sugar Alliance. We'll discuss about product-specific matters with these agriculture organizations. And also on June 11th, we shall meet with President Roger Johnson of NFU, National Farmers Union, who is also a member of WFO in Washington. And in your handout included is a joint statement from NFU and J.A. Zenchu regarding the Lima round of Trans-Pacific Partnership negotiations. The Lima round was in May. And actually here we emphasize the following. The TPP's dangers on impacting not only agriculture but also the healthcare that is emphasized, as well as the calling for the transparency, securing transparency of negotiation process. So these are the gist of our joint statement. And I very much look forward to our next meeting in June with the NFU in the United States to further our efforts.
以上 TPP 問題に関連しお話をさせていただきました。高官言われますように日本農業は高い技術力を誇っており、安全安心への配慮はもとより高品質な農畜産物を生み出しております。2015年には地中に食料、生命にエネルギーをテーマにミラノ国際博覧会が開催されますし、また現在日本政府はユネスコの無形世界遺産に和食を申請をいたしております。 J グループでいたしましてもこれらの取り組みに参画をし、これから持続可能な農業の実現を目指す日本農業の素晴らしさや日本の国土自然の中で育んできた世界に誇るべき食の魅力を国内はもとより世界に向けて積極的に発信してまいりたいと考えております。つきましては皆様方におかれましても J グループの取り組みにどうぞ引き続きご注目いただきますようにお願い申し上げます。本日はこのような大変貴重な機会をいただきまして誠にありがとうございました。
Okay, so far I have discussed about various aspects of TPP related to issues. Now we are very very proud of the top expertise of Japanese agriculture, which has always been emphasizing the safety and peace of mind for the consumers. AndThey have been provided with the highest quality agricultural and livestock products. Now, in 2015, the Expo Milano 2015, Feeding the Planet, Energy for Life, is scheduled to be held. And at present, Japanese government has proposed washoku, the Japanese food, as a UNESCO-designated intangible cultural heritage. These are the global movements emphasizing food.And JA Group is intending to, as it has always been, engaged in these actions and these agenda with concrete the actions to be taken. And we are intending to waste no time to appeal proudly and precisely, passionately, the Japanese agriculture, which has been evolving under the vision of sustainable agriculture,and appealing the charm of Japanese food, which has been cultivated in Japanese, beautiful Japanese landscape and nation. We shall continue to make these efforts and strides through our actions and appeal to the world. And ladies and gentlemen of the press, thank you very much for your patience. And I very much hope and urge you to keep watching what we have been, what we are going to be doing into the future. Thank you very much for your precious opportunity.
Okay, I will open the floor to questions from the working press first.
Thank you. Good afternoon. I'm an energy journalist, European Energy Review. We also do economical background stories for European newspapers and magazines. And I have two questions. In the first place, critics of your organization will say that you are co-responsible for the inefficiency in the Japanese agriculture because of your resistance against substantial reforms in the last decades. What is your comment on that? And my second question is, now your farmers are with the back against the wall. What kind of reforms are you willing to support? Are you, friends, are you willing to open up the sector for foreign investors outside of the sector, or for sustainable or substantial land reforms to make a large-scale agriculture possible?
日本農業も大変な状況に置かれているというのは私どもを十分認識をいたしております。それで昨日でありましたけれども、マスコミ等で報道されました通り、安倍総理に対しまして26年度以降の新農政に対する提言を申し上げてまいりました。これからの施策に生かしていただきたいということでございます。問題点はまず農地の修正率ということ、確かに規模拡大をせなきゃならんという状況にございます。それにつきましても受け皿を作りをして、我々もそういう面での農地の修正率を図ってまいりたいと。我々10年間の姿を見ますと、3ヘクタール規模の平均が今5ヘクタールまで、規模拡大がなされてきておりますので、私どももそれなりの努力をしてきております。まだまだそういう面では規模拡大が必要だという面であります。ただ日本農業のあり方は水田農業という形が中心でありまして、まず水、農水というものは緊迫度が必要だということになりますと、一戸当たりの補助の大きさというのが制限されてまいります。中山間地が4割を占める日本農業のありようとしては、なかなかその補助整備が大きくならんという、機械の効率化もうまくいかないという状況があるということだけはご理解賜りたいと思います。
The first question about the reform. Yes, I do agree that the Japanese farmers are up against the wall, and we have to do take actions to help them. And as for the actions we have been taking in support of this effort is exemplified in our approach to Prime Minister Abe. And we have actually made our proposals to Prime Minister Abe regarding 2014 agricultural policy reform. So we are actively engaged in reflecting our views as to how we can reform effectively. And as for the expansion of the scale of farming or farmland, integration of farms to increase the economy of scale, I believe, yes, I agree that this is very, very important for efficiency improvement. And in fact, that it may take substantial time, but we have been able to increase to 5 hectares per firm. And that is the reflection of our efforts. But we understand we still have a long way to go to try to increase the scale of farming. But ladies and gentlemen, there is one constraint that we have to live with for rice farming. The rice paddies in Japan, because of the nature of this terrain, and also the requirement of agricultural, the water for rice paddy farming required, which means that we need the leveling of the water supply to successfully undertake the rice cultivation. It is not possible to expand beyond a certain limit. So these are the natural constraints for rice farming. And we have this this very mountainous terrain, up to 40% of our cultivated the land, and that's why we have to live with such constraints. Nevertheless, try to enhance reform.
はい、それから農協というものはご案内の通り、これは協同組合でございます。我々小生産者が集まって、対応すると、個々の農家ができないものを農協は代わってやるという。総合事業を営んでいる共同組合でありますので、ご理解賜りたいと思います。まあ、そういう意味では、我々生産者の生産、流通、それから販売まで、川下に至るまで我々がそれに関与しながら、有利な販売ができるような体制を考えておりますし、輸出につきましても、当然、高品質なもので皆さんに提供できるように頑張ってまいりたいと思います。今政府が申し上げておりますような4500億程度のものを1兆円に伸ばすという、そういう話が出ておりますが、我々は当然、その面につきましても、輸出のビジネスにつきまして、今、検討中でありますし、さらに1兆円伸びるように努力をしてまいりたいというふうに思っているところでございます。それから、農地所有の関係を申し上げますと。
Now, as far as our role as the Central Union of Agricultural Cooperatives Japan, we believe that because of our extensive network and this organization, we are able to represent the small farmers and do the things that they cannot do on their own. And that is the role of Agricultural Cooperatives Central Union like us. And we have been proven to be very, very effective representing their interest. In terms of the developing the most efficient system for production, distribution, and sales. In other words, we take care of upstream down to downstream. That is what we can do on behalf of the farmers. And so that is the system and framework we have been able to develop over the years. And as far as exports is concerned, we do agree that in order to enhance the export,we do need to make more efforts and with the quality exports. And now the government has given this agenda that they wanted to increase exports from 450 billion worth to 1 trillion yen in export value. Now this is a very aggressive target.But we are intending to cooperate with them so that we will be able to examine various ways and means to try to develop the attractive export agricultural products to reach this target. And we are still in the process of exerting efforts to meet this target.
はい。農地の所有の話でありますが、昨日も私は安倍総理に対して意見を申し上げてまいりました。株式会社に対して農地所有は認めないでほしいという、まさに我々の日本農業のありようというのは、集落、地域という、そして共生という中で育ってきた歴史な経緯がございます、まあ、そういう中で、企業がリースという格好で農地利用というのを、農地の使い方をするというのが、私は日本農業のあったスタイルであろうと、今の状況を見ましても、リースの方が形態としてはプラスであるという。感覚でおります、まあ、そういう面では、あることがあった場合、企業が撤退した場合は原状回復がならないという心配を持っておりまして、所有権まで企業に渡すことはないようにしてほしいという要請を安倍総理には申し上げました。
Now, as far as the different types of reforms you have mentioned, including the allowing the ownership of land to theDifferent stakeholders outside of agriculture and outside of Japan. We have actually approached Prime Minister Abe recently and have provided our official view on this. Now, this is what we have proposed. We requested Prime Minister Abe not to allow the companies, companies incorporated to be engaged in this process because of the fact that the Japanese agriculture has been based on the traditional development and symbiosis of people in the small villages and communities who have been helping each other and developing and nurturing their expertise so successfully up to the present, developing quality produce. And now we believe that the best way to allow entry of corporations into this agriculture arena is through leasing of the land, not the ownership, but the leasing of the land. We requested to Prime Minister Abe, we believe this was the optimum form of engaging corporations, if we must, in this arena. And the leasing that we believe is the, going to benefit all. And the reason for this, the argument is that the corporations, when they're allowed to own the agricultural land and engage in farming, what they could possibly do is that they could simply withdraw if they felt that this certain agriculture is not profitable. So they could withdraw and leave the land just in devastated state. And they're not going to be responsible. They're just going to say, we're going to drop this land. And the recovery of the farmland is going to take such a long time, if it's at all possible. That is the reason that we believe that ownership by the corporation is not appropriate, and we requested to not to consider that to Prime Minister Abe.
Our guest has to leave at 4:05, so we don't have much time. We can go a bit over time, but you had a second part of your question. The first question was, how do you answer to the criticism that basically the JA is responsible for the inefficiency of the farming today by resisting change in the last 10 years?
I believe I answered that question. We have been making efforts to make this necessary reform.
Okay, I didn't get this so far. Okay, Rick.
Thank you for your speech. Rick Wallace from the Australian newspaper. Just a quick question. As you know, Japan and Australia are negotiating a free trade agreement and hope to conclude it before the TPP negotiations get to the business end. Do you think this agreement will be similarly damaging to Japanese agriculture, and should the Japanese government pull out of negotiating this agreement?
25FTA というのはもう7年間ぐらい、6年かな、続いております。なかなか合意でいない状況には至っておらんということに考えておりますが、FTA というのはご覧のとおり、自由貿易協定ということでありまして、日本の国も十何カ国かで FTA を結んでおりますが、センシティの事業品目を除外しているという状況がございます。ただオーストラリアとの関係におきましては、オーストラリアは大農業国でありますので、その面が政府としては決議もございますので、きちんとした対応してほしいと思いますが、なかなか今の段階では時間が要するのかなという思いであります。
オーストラリア・ジャパン FTA negotiations have been ongoing for 6 years, and the talks had not really reached conclusions. As far as FTA is concerned, Japan has been developing FTA free trade agreements with more than 10 countries. But on these occasions, we have always agreed to set aside or exclude the sensitive products. But now the negotiation talks with Australia. The Australia is such a large agricultural producing country, so it has been quite difficult to agree mutual agree. But we very much hope that the government would have to make political resolution, but would respond sensibly to meet the Japanese situation and agriculture. But I believe it is going to take more time.
日中の関係では国会決議がありますので、それに倣って交渉していると思います。
Mm. In other words, as far as Japan, Australia, FTA negotiations concerned, they have to follow the resolution by the Diet, the National Diet, and they are following the resolution faithfully to undertake the negotiations.
Carsten Germes from Frankfurter Allgemeine Zeitung in Germany. I have a question to your political strategy. Rural Japan always has been the power base of the ruling party of Prime Minister Abe. They always have been strong there. You will have upper house elections in July. If Mr. Abe wants to succeed in his policy opening for free trade, he needs a victory there as well. Do you have any strategy this time to support opposition parties to prevent this victory? Because in case he wins, you can't stop the TPP anymore.
それで今度参議院議員総選挙を7月ということでありまして、もし安倍総理が勝った場合にはですね、そうすると TPP なしぐらいに行く可能性があるので、逆に野党をサポートするというようなそういった TPP を反対させるためにね、野党をサポートするようなこの戦略はお考えでしょうか。
7月に参議院議員選挙が決行されますが、我々の思いは昨年12月の総選挙の際にもお伝えをして推薦した経緯がございます。TPP、正規なき関税撤廃を反対するという、そういう考えのもとの中で、候補者を推薦を申し上げてきました。で、安倍総理におきましても、3月15日の段階では、農業を必ず守るという。それは政権公約であり、あるいは TPP 対策委員会の決議であり、先般は衆参農林水産委員会でも決議をされております。それを遵守する。今日も石破幹事長にお会いをして、守るという力強い言葉も頂戴をしておりますので、そういう面では守っていただきたいということでありますし、我々は本当は TPP そのものは、日本農業を壊滅させるという面では断固反対だということであります。かが今、自民党なり政府の方では必ず守るという、私はその政治は信頼であるということを申し上げておりますので、ぜひとも守っていただきたいというのが私の今の立場であります。
Yes, in July, the House of Councillors election, general election is upcoming. Now, I can say this. I want to trust the words and commitment of the Prime Minister and the ruling party. And this is all I can say. Back in December, during the general election campaign, we have recommended Mr. Abe, the LDP, as a LDP leader. And at that time, we have made sure to Mr. Abe that our position is adamantly against the elimination of tariffs without sanctuary. And that was our position. And he said, yes, he's committed to protecting that position. And again, on 15th of March, he has also made this public comment and commitment that he shall, by all means, protect Japanese agriculture. So we want to keep on believing the official commitments and these comments made by the leader. And also, this has been endorsed by the TPP, the related committee, as well as the Agricultural Fisheries committee and the various committees from both houses. They have all endorsed the same position of protecting agriculture. The position against the TPP negotiations. And therefore, we want to keep watching and keep believing in the ruling party. And today I have met with Mr. Ishiba, the leader, the Secretary General, and he said, yes, you have my word. We shall protect Japanese agriculture. So these are the words that I have heard directly and also officially regarding the DPP. And our position has always been intact before and after the new administration that is against the DPP entry because that could possibly damage Japanese agriculture. And now the LDP, the ruling party, says and is committed to protecting our agriculture, and I believe in trust. Trust is everything in politics, and therefore I want to trust that our leader knows and he's going to be living up to his commitment.
Thank you very much. I have to close.